जय श्री कुसुम हरनाथ। पागल हरनाथ पार्ट 4 लेटर 22 एड्रेस टू स्वामी दयानंद। मोस्ट काइंड एंड अफेक्शनेट, रीडिंग योर लेटर एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ योर इनफाइनाइट मर्सी आई बिकेम ओवरवेल्म्ड। कैन द वर्ल्ड बी स्वेड विदाउट सच मर्सी? कैन द वर्ल्ड बी एट द फीट विदाउट सच सेल्फलेसनेस? एंड इज द फ्लड पॉसिबल विदाउट बीइंग सो आर्डेंट ए लवर? My burden exceeds the strength of your attraction. From this alone you will realize why did I come to this world and burden the sacred earth so much. The stream of love by which my most merciful Nityananda and super refined Sri Gauranga had once delivered even the insects and flies is flowing again. But such is my misfortune that I miss this opportunity too, like the earlier. My life is futile. I could not purify myself by floating and immersing myself in such a stream. How indeed will it be in my lot to see that exquisite dance, that love-soaked form, that voice choked with emotion, and that gush of love-laden tears? Lord's diktat to a dog like me that feeds on leftover food has indeed been right. Lest the great yajna becomes spoiled or unholy by my touch, the merciful Nitai has first chained his dog so that suddenly he doesn't go and put its mouth into the very sacred vessel, as is its nature. O Nitai, your compassion is great, your judgment is subtle. Where else shall I find a judge like you? However, Lord, bind me fast, but may the utensils of leftover meals be in my lot. May I have the right of having the prasad touched by the lips of your bhaktas. Do not be miserly in showing this kindness. I don't have power to express whatever is stirring in my mind, whatever is stirring in my heart, and submit to your lotus feet. My heart alone knows its pain. Oh, I have missed such an opportunity. Shame on me. My life is in vain. My birth, it seems, has been rendered meaningless. At one end is the torrent of love, and I am bound fast at the other. My condition is worse than that of a hungry man who is bound hand and feet, and before whom are placed choicest and sweetest dishes. The hunger of the hungry is to satisfy the body, and only for that moment he gets in peace. While my hunger is of the soul, and this hunger can be quenched forever by taking food for once only. So I say, my condition is infinitely worse than that of a mere hungry man. Master, I am very much put down. On this occasion, I might have accomplished two great things. One is self-purification, and the other is to see your lotus feet and meet my other affectionate fathers and mothers. I do not know why the Lord has meted out this punishment to me. After receiving your letter command and then the wire from Dr. Baba, I tried my best but could not succeed. The Maharaja of Kashmir not being here, I could on no account leave the place. Once I thought of giving up the job to go to you, but I desisted at the thought that it's not right to lose the little amount of money I'm getting after many years. However, my submission is that because I could not be present in person to purify my body, I may not, on that score, be deprived of the prasad of the Vaishnava and the dust of their feet. My prayer to the lotus feet of my master is that I may gratify myself by receiving in your letter a little leftover prasad and charanamrita. The road along which the sankirtan would move, if I can get a little dust of that road, I hope to gratify myself and to make myself greatly pure. My final prayer is that considering this lowly is a refugee at your feet, you will not forget to bestow your mercy. You all are my only saviors. The unworthy at your feet, Haro. Jai Shri Kusum Haranath.